Hey, what's going on guys, Sandeep here, and one of my video was about how you can backup your iPhone to Windows PC using iTunes, and all the iTunes backup goes into your C drive, which definitely takes some space on your C drive, and over the time your C drive gets full. And you can see that in my case, if I go to this PC, and the C drive is almost full due to the iPhone backup. Because all the backups goes into C drive by default, and I want to change the backup location to any other empty drive or external hard disk. Now, if you want to change the iTunes backup location on your Windows PC, then there are three steps. First, we need to find the iTunes backup location on our Windows PC. Second, we will move the backup folder to any other location from the C drive. And third, we will create a symbolic link from the old location to the new location. Now the first thing is to find the iTunes backup location on the Windows PC. And it depends whether you have installed the iTunes from Microsoft Store like this one. So you just open the Microsoft Store and install the iTunes, or you have installed the iTunes from the Apple's website from here. And in both cases, the iTunes backup location would be different. Now I have installed it from the Microsoft Store, then I will go to the C drive, users folder, my user account, then Apple folder. And this MobileSync folder contains the backup folder. So if you have installed the iTunes from Microsoft Store, then the location would be this one. And this backup folder contains all the data of your iPhone, all the backup file. But if you have installed the iTunes from Apple's website, then the location would be different. You just have to press Windows plus R key together on your keyboard to open the run dialog box and type there ampersand AppData then ampersand. Now click on OK. And you will see the roaming folder. Inside the roaming folder, you will find a folder named Apple and then additional folders and then backup folder. And I will mention the backup location in the video description as well. Now the first step is complete. Let's move to the second. Now we need to move the backup folder from the C drive to any other drive where we want to save it. So I will right click on it and cut the backup folder. And let's paste it into any other drive. Like F, or I think I would paste it into E drive. Let's paste it here. Now it will take some time depending on the existing backup size. So you have to wait till the process is complete. Now once it is done, we need to create a symbolic link from the old backup location to the new backup location. Old backup location was inside MobileSync. And now this new backup location. And one more thing, you can also rename the backup folder name as per your choice so that you can easily find your iTunes backup. Right click and rename. It totally depends on your choice. I would like to rename it iTunes backup. So it is done. We just need to create a link, interlink from the old backup location to the new backup location. It is something like creating a junction from the old location to the new location so that iTunes will backup all the file in old location but it will transfer to the new location. For that you have to execute certain commands. Now if you have downloaded it from the Apple's website, iTunes from the Apple's website, you have to execute this command. But if you have installed it from the Windows Store, then you have to execute this command on the CMD. But you have to replace your username and the backup location, the new backup location. In my case, it is E drive and iTunes backup. So I will type E colon iTunes backup and here I will replace my username. You can find your username by clicking on start menu and this is your username. In my case, it is itechfever space PC. So I will type that username here. And I will provide these commands in the video description as well. So let's type the username itechfever space PC. Now copy whole command. Just copy, right click and copy. Now search for command prompt and run it as admin. Click on the yes option, you will get on the screen. Now simply right click to paste the command and press enter on your keyboard. And you will get this message, junction created for the old location between new location. So this command will create a junction between two locations. Now if you go to mobile sync folder, you will get a backup folder with shortcut icon. But it is not a shortcut, but a symbolic link from the old backup location to the new backup location. All the backups would go from this backup location to the newer backup location. And you are done. You can exit out CMD and synchronize your iPhone using iTunes. Now let's go to the C drive. You can see that I have some empty space on the C drive. Now let's connect the iPhone to Windows PC and open iTunes and synchronize it. Let's open iTunes. And click on device icon, and you can see that I am able to synchronize my iPhone. I am able to backup, and all the backups would go to the new location. I have tried and tested and verified everything. And that's all for this video, guys. Hope this helped. If so, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. Also, press the bell icon to get notified about new videos, and I will see you in my next video.